Hassan said he doesn't care about the term and would rather jump off a bridge. Man, I wonder if Hassan doesn't like me anymore. That's interesting. We used to have a great relationship. We hung out a couple times. It's interesting. Maybe there's something about my politics now where Hassan has cut me off. I don't even really know. It's really weird. We have a lot of mutual friends and stuff where I have no problem. Hassan's been talking about it all day. He doesn't like you're associated with Destiny. I'm no more associated with Destiny than I am with him. The last time I saw one of them, I saw the other. We did the same thing. We just went to dinner. It's kind of interesting. Let's see what's going on. Hassan Twitch. I'm curious what's happening over there. Yeah, it's interesting. I mean, I would actually be, it would be sad if he cut me off. Oh my God. What on earth? All right, let's give it a second. And we're still standing by for Joe Biden, by the way. Yeah, no, I don't know. But I see a lot of pretty aggressive rhetoric here. I don't really know about any of that stuff. But I can only report to you my experience. Let's see.
Burning cross to a black conservative who said being black is lit. He said, oh, is that...
Oh, wait, so is he just doing Destiny content?
And be like, oh my God, I'm so offended that people are using the term gusano, a term that most people had to fucking Google immediately after I fucking mentioned it for the first time ever. And it's actually certainly not political can only be used against Cubans. And it's not just a catch-all fucking term that a lot of leftist Latin Americans use against people that they perceive to be like capitalist, anti-imperialist, counter-revolutionaries. I'm so offended. I'm so offended.
What?
It's just the same shit. This dude literally just uses social justice and people of color as a fucking prop just to like be like, I'm so offended on behalf of everyone else. He's no different than he's the edgy.
What?
SJW with fucking blue hair. Okay. That's all he is. He literally just weaponizes social justice when it's appropriate and then writes a fucking manifesto about trying to. Trying to defend that, like, all the black people calling him out for saying the N-word in private are actually wrong and racist.
What?
And racist. Like, I'm sorry, dude. Once you say, you want to mow down fucking BLM protesters, like, you've lost the high ground on an argument that you want to make about fucking a political term that you are now choosing to be offended. Okay? God damn. Gusano is literally in the same fucking vein as Karen. A certain type of behavior,
which I'm against, yeah,
for a sex technically, okay, and in the same vein as like saying cracker or honky or redneck, it is a language, it is a term.
Those are pretty bad terms, guys. I don't know,
have come up with to describe the conditions of their oppression and the continued conditions of their oppression by those who would wish to oppress them.
Okay. I don't know, most of the people I see using the term gusano don't seem too oppressed to me, guys. I don't know.
About this is being absolutely ridiculous. Having said that, do a lot of people on the left, I guess, utilize this word against anyone that they're like, oh, are you Cuban? Well, you're a gusano because you fucking criticize Cuba. Like, oh, shut the fuck up.
I think what he's missing is the racial element of the term.
Fuck up. Like, just stop fucking calling every Cuban person a gusano. You're not.
I haven't seen a Hassan stream for a while. Is this what it always is? Because I can see, I mean, I see why he has so many followers, because it's like rage, high level rage all the time. That I can see why he's doing so well. I mean, good for Hassan.
In Cuba, whether it be legitimate claims that they have to get more food and medical supplies, or to lift the fucking embargo that has been going on for.
I'm with that. I'm with all of that. Yeah, okay. I'm with all of that. But you're never going to hear me praise an authoritarian regime that's been in power for 50, 60 years, you know,
is a total diversion. And it's exclusively centering around what mostly predominantly white American fucking liberals want to argue about, because it's about the sport. It's not about uplifting Cuba or Cuban people. It's just about the support. It's just about the sport of debate, the blood sport that revolves around debating and like winning an argument with semantics.
Right. No, I actually agree with, in the sense that like I'm not really interested. I'm not trying to be the anti-imperialist or the capitalist or what, you know. It's just like, hey, the embargo is a disaster. It's failed. We got to help with elements of medical, and we can't defend any authoritarian regime. You know what I mean? It's just like it's sort of like everybody would disagree with some aspect. Many people would disagree with some aspect of that. But I think the blood sport aspect, he's rightly identifying that is bad.
Slurs that are considered fucked up, for the record. So I just want you to know that, like, he is absolutely, absolutely fucking just engaging in this just to be like, come on, dude. I'm just trying to claw into that fucking relevance. Okay.
Mm. Yeah.
He's not. He's a ridiculous person. It's an unserious person. And this is an unserious conversation.
I feel like we could have dinner again and it would be fine. You know, we Hassan, Stephen, Kenneth Destiny, Benel the Second, and I had Indian food, and Melina, Destiny, Benel the Second came with us, and my manager came with us, who's a friend of Hassan's. It was great. It was a good day. I think that it would be totally fine. I feel like I'd be able to negotiate it all and everybody would be fine.
Destiny tells an interesting story about Hassan. This is a lie. He said in his chat that...
All right. Anyway, let's get away from this. I think we've seen enough, and here we go.